Hi guys, in this video I'm going to demonstrate linear regression using Python. I'm going to be using sklearn and Anaconda and Jupyter notebook. This is my Anaconda prompt, and if you are a beginner and you don't know how to start your Anaconda application, the process is after you installed and configured Anaconda and Jupyter, after you open the Anaconda prompt, you will be shown this sort of a terminal, command prompt, and then you have to navigate to the folder where you want to place your files, or where you want to save your files, or where your files exist. So in my case, I'm going to navigate to H drive and then to the folder. Just use CD for change directory. And after you reach on the folder where your files exist, what you do is start Jupyter notebook. So the command to start Jupyter notebook is somewhere here. It is, yeah, just have to write Jupyter notebook and the application will start. Then it will give you a temporary URL. Copy this and paste it in your browser and you are all set. These are all the files, and I've already created a new file. The process to create a new file is click on new and click on Python 3. Excuse me. Okay, so after you create the new file, we can write the code here, and as you can probably understand, it is easier for us to write code here than on the Python 3 GUI kit which we get. So let's start with the code. So pandas, sklearn, matplotlib, this is already pre-installed with Anaconda, so that is why we prefer Anaconda over a normal installation where you have to separately install them. So let's start with importing the necessary libraries. So import pandas as pd, then import sklearn dot datasets, from this import edis dataset. So the name is load edis, and then we need to import the linear model for linear regression. So from sklearn import linear model, and then import matplotlib dot pyplot, pyplot, pyplot as plt. Well, I'm going to tell you how you can remember this. Actually, you don't need to remember this, since you have a browser, you have internet connection, you can always search the documentation, and it's pretty easy actually. So in Python, the way to import libraries is like this: import something as something, like instead of writing pandas all the time, we have to just write pd. Then this is how we import libraries. Now you want to load the edis dataset. So Google, write something like sklearn load the edis dataset. Then you will be probably redirected to the sklearn website where there is a documentation which shows how to load all the datasets. There are more than one dataset. There are other datasets. I'm going to use the edis dataset, but you can use any other dataset which you want. And then import the linear model, because it's already there in sklearn. To import it, and then matplotlib to plot the graph. We don't really need it for the prediction, but in case you want to plot it and all, you can use it. So let's try to run this and see if there is any error. So click on this button or icon to run the application. So as you can see, there were no errors in this part of the code, so it's time to move on. Now let's try to load the actual iris data set. So iris is equal to load iris. Let's run this and see, no error. And now let's try to print the data set. Okay, sometimes it causes some problem, but it usually works. I'm gonna pause this video and see why this is happening. It does not really happen. Like, in case this happens, just stop the kernel, then try to start it again and see if it works, or you can restart the kernel and see if everything works properly. And I'm going to pause this video now and see what is the problem and how to come back and address the issue. Alright, let's continue with our execution. Well, I don't know what the problem was, but I restarted my application, my Jupyter notebook, from the command prompt twice, and then it is working perfectly. So okay, let's move on. Now let's see the iris dataset. Just write iris and run this. And you can see all the features or the description and everything about the dataset here. So the first item is DESCR, which is the short form of description. So this gives a brief description about the dataset here. And then if you scroll down a bit, you can find something as feature list. Where's the feature list? I'm finding something as feature list. So feature name. So the feature name gives you the name of the headings, like sepal width, petal length, petal width. This is the sepal width, petal length, sorry, sepal width, petal length, petal width. First is sepal length, so this is this. Then is sepal width, the second one. Third is petal length, the third one. Fourth is petal width, the fourth one. So this is it. And this is a target, means 0 means the first variant, 1 means the second variant, and 2 means the third variant. So yeah, the first one is Cetosa. Then is, alright, you can read the names. The first one is Cetosa, then I cannot read this actually. I cannot. So as you can see, you can get the data here like this. And if you do something like this, it was DESCR, you can get only the description. And this is nice actually, because with this we can get all the individual things, like target. If you write target, we can get on the target, and if we write data, we can get only the data. So this thing we'll be using later on. So the next part is where to create the data frame, the x and y. X means our input and y means our output. So df underscore x, which is a short form of data frame x, is equal to pd, means we're using pandas dot data frame. And in this, as a parameter, we have to pass the iris dataset, iris.data, and the columns. Note the name, it is columns and not column. So columns is equal to iris.featureName. I taught you how to find the name. It was feature name from there, and we can use it. And for dfy means the data frame y. We have to make the data frame like this, in the same way as dfx. So pd dot data frame, then iris dot target. So we are done with creating the data frame. Let's see if we have some error here. And yeah, there is some error. Let's see what the error is. Feature name. Okay, there is no feature name, I guess. So let's do something. Let's write iris again and let's see what it was called. It was feature names. Okay, feature names. So that was my problem, not feature name, feature names. So copy it and the last one, paste it. Feature names. So now it won't have any problem. Yeah, okay, there's no problem now. Now we have got our data frames, and now let's try to make the regression model. So REGR, the regression model, is equal to linear model, and then linear model dot linear regression. So this is created, and then we have to fit the model. So REGR dot fit, and then we have to pass in the data frames dfx and dfy, dfx and dfy. So after fitting the data frames, dfs is not defined. Okay, it is small x. Okay, yeah. So if you get this line, it means that the fitting is done, and then we can use this to predict our output on some data. So to predict some output, we have to do something like this. Print it, if you want to print the output, that is. So print REGR regression dot predict, and then dfx minus 10 colon. What this means is we are going to just put in the last 10 values of the array, and this will predict the last 10 values of the array. And yeah, you can get the output something like this. 2.0, it's predicting, it's not exactly accurate, because if you remember, the last 10 values were all 2, and it's giving more or less a good result, except the last one, which is giving 1.6. so all the results like 2 and 1 and 2, like 1.9 and all, these are all good. 1.8, 1.7 is more or less good. This is not a good result. So this is how to use how to implement linear regression using Python. And yeah, this is it. And in my website I have given a more or less detailed code of this, like you can just copy paste it. I'm going to show you the link. So just go to google.com. okay, or actually like this, the Tinker project at co.in, then blog, and then okay, then this is no, it is this one. Yeah, linear regression Python. So this is more or less the same code which I used, and I've used plotter here also. I not use this in the code here, but I used it here. You can see how to use it. And actually you have to maintain the indentation, but somehow the website, when I'm inserting the code, I'm not able to put in the indentation. Anyways, you can see this, this is the link. I will put this in the description also. You can copy the code, you can see. So this is all for this video. If you like it, do it a thumbs up and keep coding. Thank you.